We are using this library, interesting library, the LIP. The LIP library is a machine learning algorithms tools creating complex software in C++. It's interesting for some applications. In this board, got four CPUs, and we can use these for interesting execution programs. In the LIP, the LIP gets some examples. This is my path of to load an installation. We got examples. Then we compile by default in this build, and it's already compiled. But if you want to compile just one example, sometimes it's difficult. For me, it was difficult, but in this case, I'm gonna teach you how to. Well, in this case, I am using this path. This is my personal path. This is my code folder, C++ folder, the lib folder, and examples. This is use copy and paste examples, no more. Well, here, for example, we got at this example. This is an interesting application of 3D point cloud. And here is the execution file. Use delete to compile. Delete. Well, in this case, in our terminal, we are in the folder. Ready? And here we need to use some of these compiling eccentric code. Well, first, G++. Space lest std equal to C++11 space and less 0. This is 0. No, this is O. Okay, you just need to put O3 space, use one space, and the letter. Capital letter I, and where is your download the lib folder? Your installation folder. A space, and you need to use where is the source CPP code? Well, in this case, we can to see this thing. For example, I got in downloads my the lib all source CPP. And again, this library, this another library. And for another example, I was using this FHawk. This is a GPA. Okay, this is a picture example. And for that reason, I was using this code, FHawk X, for example, in this case. But you can use the same execution code. Well, here you can pause the video and see in high quality all the code. It's not difficult, but it's too long. The most important thing is this space to take where is the source. Okay, I'm using Arbian. Well, you can paste by shift plus insert, and here what we can to compile is this 3D point cloud. We're going to make some zoom, and we can to see code here, O3. Remember, O3. This is what we got, and the source and the 3D point cloud. It takes some time, maybe near to 60 seconds, maybe. It takes time. You can to see that the voltage is down, maybe the dot 2 volts, 0.2 volts, it's down. And in the H top is the frequency utilization of our is our performance board utilization. You can see that it's on a one CPU to the 100%. It takes a few seconds, maybe a minute. Well, we can to see that it finished, and in our file compiling examples is here the application execution file. Well, in this case we're going to show you this execution file is this. It is where we can to see, and here is our display. And what we see is a cloud point 3D is showing. It's interesting, it's an interesting application. We maximize the window, and we can with the mouse we can move this. Is interesting, so interesting. Well, you can use this code to compile your the leap project. It's interesting, very interesting, just to test. Okay, and here, okay, we go out. Let's go to compile the, for example, another example. For example, face detection. Face detection is so interesting. We are not using the default build, like you can see here. We are using our compiling file. Well, another example that we can to run, for example, is this face detection. We compile, and then we can to run face detection x. And what is the file? The file is on home iMac. It's just my, what is my file, my picture, C++, delete, oh goodness. Sorry, delete, examples, faces, ladies, punto. We suppose is ready. We can to see here where are the faces, and this is an our picture, and our original picture is this, ladies. This is our original picture that we can see, and this is the picture that the computer process. You can see this red square in each face. Okay, it's an interesting, very interesting exercise for machine learning. This is just the test of an example. The proposal is cover this in a personal project, a project that we can to use in this Thinkerboard. Well, thank you. Well, this is another example, but we are just going to use this another library, Armadillo. Of C++. This is a linear algebra library. This is a high quality algebra library for use matrix max on C language. You can use this documentation and installation of this. It's a very interesting library. And here what we are going to use is an example of the compiling of an inverse of a matrix of 1000 by 500 a square matrix. In this case, we are going to take the clock to see how much time it takes and how many seconds to make an inverse of a random matrix of 1500 square matrix. It's used a conversion. We can to see how is the Thinkerboard performance with this operation, with this simple operation. Well, here in our terminal we can call this compiling. The compiling is this. The code to compile is so simple. You can to see it. This is an our code in inf a cpp the object in a and the library el armadillo, and here we can to call this and take note of the time. Inf a. That's everything. Beginning and I don't know how many time it takes, and it takes 10 seconds to make the inverse of this matrix. Not bad, not bad for this small board. And let's go to see again with the voltage, taking the voltage in the screen. Okay, let's go to press enter. There you go. And you can to see the voltage drops. And it's almost done. Done. Okay, not bad. Let's go to see again with the memory. You can to see this terminal to see the memory. Call again. You can to see 100, and the memory is maybe not bad. It's using just one processor, and it's ready. Not bad for this small single bar computer.